There's nothing quite as comforting as simple home cooking. Today, recipes from my neck of the woods, Cumbria. We're creating glorious dishes to remind me of home, using the most amazing local produce. The Cumberland sausage, the most famous sausage in the world. Now, this is like a shortened version. It's a bit like those kind of, well, you know, like the cut-down novels, do you know what I mean? That this is a little Cumberland, but it's quite acceptable for a tray bake. First off, some oil in your tin. I want onion wedges.
I'll tell you what I'm doing. I'm just going to prepare this butternut scotch.
Now, you could use other sausages, but, you know, I like Cumberland sausages because they're peppery and they're full of meat.
So we're going to add bone in, chicken thighs. The reason that we've kept the bone on, it just adds flavour, doesn't it? And the beautiful, beautiful skin goes all crispy and lovely, and you want that. It's a comforting dish, this. It's lush.
You could take the skin off if you wanted. You could take the bones out.
Cumberland sausage in there as well.
Lovely.
And then, on top of that...
You haven't peeled the squash.
Well, it's rustic, innit? It's kind of... All the ingredients in this is pretty basic, and it's great because it's quick.
Now, I'm just going to strip some thyme onto there. Sprinkle it all over.
While Dave's doing that, I'm going to put a little bit of salt and some pepper in there as well.
Good glug of olive oil on top of there. Beautiful. Now, I've got 100ml of water and about 50ml of red wine. And that's it for the first stage. We pop that into a preheated oven, 180 degrees Celsius, for half an hour. Do you ever go Cumberland wrestling?
Oh, yeah.
Yeah.
No, you alert yourself.
I'll be all right. Gentle. What Cumberland wrestling, it's like sumo, but they wear like white tights and you stand on a hilltop and you like this, you go.
And then you try and tip each other up.
Quite late, that.
Get up now. No.
We've done the demonstration. Right, see you in a bit. Lovely. It's bits like this that really brighten up your dish. Whoa. There's nothing goes better than chicken and mushrooms, sausage and mushrooms. So we're going to put a layer of sliced mushrooms on. And again, we're keeping these quite rustic. See, that's just started to turn now, hasn't it?
It is lush.
Well, that looks nice, Kingy.
Doesn't it?
Now the glaze. We have a tablespoon of maple syrup.
It's a lovely glaze, this.
Oh, aye. And a teaspoon of red wine vinegar. So we've got sweet and savoury.
So you're just dabbing that on, aren't you?
Yeah.
It's nice. You get an even more even coating then, don't you?
We do, and on the sausage as well. There we go. Now, because we Cumbrians are bang on in the 21st century, it's not traditional, but we like a bit of oomph, and it can be cold up there. So I reckon about half a teaspoon of chilli flakes. Beautiful. Roast for a further 25 to 30 minutes until everything is cooked through and well browned. Now, alongside this, we're going to serve some cavolone nero. It's like a super duper cabbage, fresh from the garden. Now, it is quite a robust green, this, and although it's not fashionable, it's quite nice if it's cooked down for quite a while.
Mm.
From the garden.
Oh, hey, beautiful. I like cavolone nero because there's a slight bitterness to it and depth.
Yeah.
It's great.
Great with pasta, isn't it? Or,
absolutely.
Or great with minestrone. I might as well chuck this thyme in, eh?
Yeah, why not?
I'll strip it off first. I don't want stalks.
Oh, it's so lovely. It's
proper winter green, isn't it?
Yeah, I love it.
Just some lemon zest?
Yeah, please, man. Put a little bit of salt in there as well. Add a little bit of water. Not too much. What we'll do, a little bit of nutmeg in that.
But nutmeg's great on spinach too, isn't it? It's lovely.
Beautiful. Right, a little bit.
If you turn that off, you don't want to burn the meg.
No. Perfect. It's surprising, isn't it? You just cook it down for about 15 minutes, 20 minutes.
Yeah.
Boom. Done. Absolutely gorgeous.
Oh, get in. Oh, all that walking and drinking tea, dude, I'm exhausted.
And that's what you need. Look at that.
Oh, look at that. And do you know what we call pork sausages up where I'm from? Snadgers. Look at the blush on those snadgers. Do you know why they call sausages bangers? Because in World War II, you know, they used to pump the sausages full of water to make them go further. You put them on a plate and they went bang. That's why they're called bangers. But these are Cumbrian snadgers. I've got to go for a sausage.
Oh.
Mm. Oh, that takes me back. That's a proper midweek winter's dish. Or after a hike on a Sunday.
Mm.
Mm. That cavolo nero is superb,
isn't it?
Mm. It's indulgent, it's unctuous and buttery.
Tell you what though, dude.
Mm.
I might be rustic, but I think if we're doing this again, we'll peel the butternut squash.
All right, poppin'.